Do you know 99% of the time battery life issues causes by the software and not by the hardware, and changing some setting, especially in iOS 15, will help you to save battery life on your iPhone. Hello everyone, I'm Nikhil from iGeeks blog, and today in this video, I promise that changing these 20 plus settings in iOS 15 will help you to save battery life on your iPhone. But before I share them all, I would like to request you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and along with that, turn on all the notifications to never miss any such great update from us. Now, if you have done that, let's talk about the very first setting. So first on the list is my favorite setting is about location service. Navigate to settings, privacy, location services, scroll all the way down and select system services. These are the hidden services in iOS which keep GPS service active on iPhone and eat up a lot of battery. So turn off location access for Apple Pay and merchant identification, compass calibration, device management, HomeKit, location based alerts and suggestions, motion calibration and distance, networking and wireless, setting time zone if you are not a frequent traveler to abroad, share my location, sharing framework, system customization, and Wi-Fi calling. Make sure you keep location service active for emergency call, find my iPhone, and mobile network search. Now on the same screen, stop sharing iPhone analytics and routing traffic, which runs in the background and shares our iPhone usage data with Apple, so that can improve our iOS user experience. No need to share them, and we need to save the battery first, so turn them off. Now right above that, select significant location. Turn it off right now as it tracks you all the time and keeping a record of where you have been during a day or a week. Next is the all new feature by Apple, and that is Private Relay. If you are subscribed to iCloud Plus, then you must be using Private Relay. It's in a beta for now and impacting our battery a lot. It will also slow down our web browsing experience, so better not to use it. Next on the list is notification, which are the biggest battery drainer. Like every time we receive a notification, iPhone screen wakes up and that consumes more battery power. And in iOS 15, Apple offered us a different ways to get notified and save battery life too. The first is customized focused mode. Add the application to the list from which you want to get notified. Another is the notification summary, just in case if you don't want to use focus mode and want to separate the notification that are not important, then you can add it to the notification summary and it will be delivered to you at your desired time. Next on the list is the voice assistant Siri. Keeping listen to Hey Siri on is listening to you all the time and keeps the microphone turned on all the time. Also, sometimes it will also pick up the false trigger and that it ups a battery life. It's better to keep it off, and whenever you want to activate the Siri, just press and hold the side or home button to activate the Siri. Now let's tweak some setting in accessibility, and the first on the list is sound recognition. It's a new feature and helping people with a hearing problem to detect and notify their nearby sound. And not everyone needs this feature. So just turn it off and that will stop keeping the microphone active all the time. Now head over to display and text, and over here toggle up the switch next to reduce the white point. It will dim your iPhone screens and will consume less battery power. Also toggle on the switch next to auto brightness for a better experience and save battery life too. Next is to control the motion effects in iPhone. Head over to motions, toggle off the switch next to autoplay message effects and video previews. Also toggle on the switch next to reduce motion and prefer crossfade transitions. Many of us are keeping the setting to iPhone auto lock time for a 3 or a 5 minutes or never. And that is the another biggest battery power consumption. I usually keep it for a 30 second or for a minute, and that helping me a lot to save battery life. Another feature we love is Race to Wake, and not every time we need this feature to keep it turned on. It may happen many times that it triggered falsely and that moment impacting on the iPhone's battery life. So avoid that and turn off raise to wake feature on iPhone and just double tap on the screen or use the side or home button to wake up the iPhone screen. The next tip is to suggest using a dark mode on your iPhone. You may hear that the less bright spot on the screen means less battery consumption. That's true, but the actual tech behind using a dark mode is to turn off OLED pixel. In dark mode, OLED pixels are off when not in use and that consumes less battery. And that's why it's my favorite feature on iPhone. The next setting is classic and proven to save battery life, that is turning off vibration. Go to settings, sound and haptics, turn off vibration on ring, and I guess that is not needed all the time. There are more settings to turn off, which are keyboard clicks. Like every time we type something will generate the click sound and eat up a battery. In the same way, lock sound also eat up a little bit of battery, and system haptic that generate vibration on haptic action. Turning them off will help to save battery life on our iPhone. Picking some setting in the music app will also help you to save battery life, and that is switching audio quality on mobile data streaming to high efficiency. Like streaming music on a high quality will consume more data and that will impact on a battery life too. So I suggest changing this setting. Now it's a time to find out major battery eater on your iPhone. So look at the battery chart and find the red spikes. Those red spike moments are the most impacted on the iPhone battery life. Take a look at the apps and you can take action to delete them if that is not that important. Also, look for high spikes and check for the apps. At that moment, those applications eat up a battery a lot, and the moment for you to think which is more important, battery life or that application. Decide and take the action. Now, if you have made your mind to delete that application, then the next tip I'm going to share is that you never heard before and it may sound crazy to you, and that is delete application. It helps in two different ways. Number one is to run application in the background even if we are not using them. And second is to free up some space on iPhone, and again that will lead to less storage, less reading time, less process time and less battery consumption. Deleting those applications one by one is kind of boring, but there is a way to delete them all quickly. Open App Stores, tap on the profile icon. Now under the update section, pick the application that you want to delete. Just swipe left and delete option will appear. Do the same for multiple apps to delete them quickly. Autoplay videos in the App Store eats up a battery and data too. Turn them off and it will help to save battery life on your iPhone. One more tip, and again that is controversial. Force quit the app when not in use. Because it's an app, it might have a bug. It may run all the time in the background. It may acquire space on RAM. It may crash and it may freeze the iPhone. And that impacts on battery life too. So force quit the application when not in use. If you have changed all the settings, then let Siri shortcut help you to save the battery life by turning on low power mode when your iPhone reaches to the certain battery percentage. Open Shortcuts app, create personal automation. Over here, select battery level and now set the percentage like 40%. Now add action to set low power mode on and turn off ask before running and tap on done. Turning on low power mode will stop background app refresh, dim the iPhone display, and we all know that helps to save battery life. Now, one last tip to avoid heat. We all know that heat is the enemy of battery. So make sure you avoid such environment and also make sure not to use your iPhone extensively when it is heating up. And with this last setting, we have reached the end of these videos, and I'm sure you are always in the search for iPhone and iOS hacks. So I must say your search is ending over here by downloading our iGeeks Blog app. Download our app and enjoy the exclusive content about everything Apple. Now please do one more favor by liking this video and sharing this video with your family and friends. And allow me to say goodbye. I'm Nikhil signing off. Thanks for watching. Stay safe. Stay connected.